In the world of nursing education, simulation is one of the most important tools that is used by educators to teach the nurses of tomorrow. Simulation provides training that is hands-on, interactive, and realistic. This technology gives nurses, at many different levels, a chance to hone their skills in a way that prepares them for real-world practice. At Duke University School of Nursing, we use the very latest technology and hardware to create a high-quality simulation experience for our students. But providing that knowledge is not our only objective. We also focus on the design and delivery of high-quality nursing education. And a part of that focus is developing the next generation of teaching tools. In this 360 episode, we're looking at an application called Task Trainer VR, a new educational tool that's being developed by the Duke University School of Nursing and the Durham VA to help distance learners gain skills by practicing in virtual reality. Dr. Michael Zykowitz describes the need behind the development of this technology.
When Ethan and I started working together, we identified a need for enhancing the way we teach distance-based nurse practitioner students. When we work with our nurse practitioner students, they come to campus for a few days each semester, and when they come here, we teach them a variety of psychomotor skills. What I believe is the use of virtual reality and simulation can be utilized for those people all over the U.S., all over the world, to practice specific healthcare skills, and then when they come to campus, they're at a higher level. We can teach them and enhance their understanding of specific skills when they're with their faculty members on campus.
Task Trainer VR Simulation provides a proof of concept platform that has tremendous potential. Ethan Birch, a simulation fellow at the Durham VA, worked with Dr. Zykowitz to develop the concept using his background in game design and existing technologies like the Oculus to create the application.
Our joint injection simulation works by having these sensors right here track your movement in the real world. So you enter the simulation by putting on a headset and then using these controllers to track your hands within the simulation.
So this is the environment inside the simulation. It's the standard doctor's office. And we have our patient model right here, who is being quite patient and generous with his time by waiting. These are my hands within the simulation, and they follow my movement within real life and the controllers. So when I make a fist, the hands in the simulation also make a fist. So what I'm gonna do is reach over and grab the needle. So as part of our tutorial, these guidance lights are for students to show them where they need to inject the needle into this person's joint. So following these, I'm going to do that. And because they did such a great job, I got some fireworks.
Ethan says that with technology advances that are on the horizon, this new type of VR simulation will be widely available and easy for students to access.
Within the next 5-10 years at the most, we're all going to have phones that are powerful enough to do room scale virtual reality, and they will be affordable on a mass market level. So what we're going to be seeing is a wider adoption of virtual reality once this is just possible and cheaper. So tools such as this simulation are only going to become more prevalent as the years pass.
In the near future, as Ethan said, in about 5 years, we're going to see the accessibility of these types of VR tools increase. We're going to see the ability for people to use both virtual reality and augmented reality in their homes widely scale. And to the educational point, we're going to be using virtual reality and augmented reality in ways that we can't even imagine yet in the classroom.
And while this particular simulation tool is in the early stages of development, Dr. Zykowitz says that it has great potential for distance learning in the near future.
So the possibilities for this type of virtual reality tool are really limitless. The current games that we have for simulation, computer-based games for simulation, are really click and play type games, where the virtual reality type game immerses you in an environment and you can move specific objects. Instead of just clicking on a needle, you actually grab and lift a needle.
This collaborative effort to develop new teaching tools between the Durham VA and the School of Nursing is emblematic of the unique teaching and learning that takes place at Duke. Not only do we provide today's highest quality simulation learning experiences, we are also hard at work to design and deliver tools for tomorrow's most advanced and effective nursing education.